Welcome back. In this session, we are going to understand how do we create a role for a particular data set. If you want to include or create a role in a particular data set, how do we do it? Very simple. Instead of me talking, if I explain it with an example, it would be very nice for you. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Let's take up some data set. In samples, there are a lot of data sets available under the title data. So I'm going to take something called as Titanic, and you click Titanic, you get a lot of details there in the Titanic data set, as the passenger, name, sex, age, number of siblings, parents, ticket number, and lot more details are there. So we are going to take this data set and we are going to play around with it right now. How do we do it? I'm going to drag and drop it first. Once we do it, almost 30% of the work is done. What else are we going to do? Very simple. I'm going to keep my pointer here and I'll show you something here called as a role. The role is all empty here, and that's what we are going to include. We are going to keep a role here, and that's going to be very easy for you to understand. Followed by role, if you see that, we have got a lot of content here which talks about the name, type, range, missings. Name is nothing but the field names, the passenger name, sex, age, number of siblings, etc. The type is nothing but something similar to the data type. That's all. It's the data type. And then the range, then missings. All these are mentioned here clearly, and it's very easy for you to understand once you try. Now, what am I going to do next? I'm going to discretize it. What do you mean by discretizing? It's very simple. I'm going to get you a better visualization in terms of grouping the data. For example, I can discretize it very nicely with respect to age group. I can discretize it as age group 1, 2, and 3. So how are you going to do that, sir? I'm going to show you a simple example, and I will show you that so that you can understand that very easily. So discretizing is an option that is available here under binning, and we are familiar with discretize by binning, and it's very easy for you to do, and I have pulled it here. So we are getting discretizing by binning. Now what do we do? We'll have to connect it. Without connecting, nothing works, and double click it. So I'm going to just double click it so that you get the complete contents here, I mean the parameters here. What is the type of the attribute filter that you are going to use? I'm going to use all single subset, or what is that you want to go ahead with? I'm going to go ahead with single parameter, and you need to also select the attribute. Which attribute are you going to use? I'm going to use the attribute called as age, and number of bins can be set as 3. What do you mean by this? Very simple. I'm going to group, I'm going to discretize the data set with respect to age into 3 bins. Bin 1, bin 2, and bin 3. That can be called as a range. That's why I can exactly tell you. That can be called as a range for it. It's very simple. Now, what is the next thing that we need to do? We need to set the role. How do we set the role, sir? Very simple. We can search for set role operator, and that's going to be useful as well. Set role is available here under the names and the roles, and drag and drop it here, connect it, and that's all. We are done with it. But do we have anything else available, sir? Yes, we need to go ahead with something more. And here, if you see that in attribute, I have to select what is the type of attribute that I'm going to pick up. So I'm going to select the attribute as survived. I'm going to get the attribute as survived. And what is the target role? What is the target role that we are keeping? So label. So I can choose it as anything here, regular ID label. So I choose the label. That's all. I'm done with it, and I'm connecting it to the result. Now, once I run it, you will be able to clearly visualize what exactly I tried to do. I have a data set. I am adding a particular role in the data set because there is nothing called as role available here, and I am discretizing it very clearly. That's it. Let's run it right now. And if you see that here, I have added the survived column here, and yes, no, this detail is available. It's binary. Yes or no is available if they have survived or not. And what I have done, I have grouped them in the, this is called binning. I binned them into range 1, 2, and 3. So you can see that here the age group is properly done, the grouping is properly done, and now it is survived with age group as range 1, 2, or 3 appropriately, and the rest of the things remain the same. So what did I do? Very simple. I added a role, and that's it. It's very easy for you to understand now. So all these are, you can try it out. All these are very simple, and this is really easy when you try it out. If you have any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer them. I hope you understood the way the demo has been done. We included this, and I hope you understood how exactly it worked. We used the Titanic data set for you to get the complete understanding of how things work. So that's it. So survived or not is the new thing that we have included. That's it. Thank you very much. If you have questions, please type it in the comment section. I'll come back to you with the answer. Thank you.